Food, water, and air are the three most important things we need in order to survive. Well, a fourth would be Wi-Fi, obviously. Now, in order to survive, we need to replenish these things whenever we can. But what if you couldn't replace them? How long could you go without them? And what would happen to you? First, let's start with oxygen, because that's what the body needs the most immediately. The average human can hold their breath for about 30 to 60 seconds, but can hold their breath for around 6 minutes before blacking out. Since you black out in this amount of time, by the way, it's impossible to kill yourself by holding your breath, since breathing is mostly voluntary. Assuming you don't have access to any accessible oxygen, it's only a couple minutes before your death. But the whole 6 minutes thing is for holding your breath, which, if you're a sane person, which hopefully you are, you would fill your lungs to your full capacity before trying. If you were deprived of oxygen by being in a place with little to no accessible oxygen, it would be much, much quicker. On the top of Mount Everest, for example, you would only have 2 to 3 minutes to live, and in space, you would have only 60 to 90 seconds. By the way, no, you would not explode in space. It would just be extremely painful and agonizing for the first 15 seconds, because that's when you're still conscious. When it comes to thirst, the average human will only last 4 or 5 days. During that time, your urine becomes darker to conserve water, you urinate less, and the brain doesn't exactly function properly. Humans are about 65% water, and we lose about 2.5 liters of it every day. The record for the longest time gone without water was set in 1979 by an Austrian teen who survived for 18 days without water. This is definitely not a record you should try to break. The only reason, in fact, he went so long without water is because the police forgot that they left him in a holding cell. And finally, we go to food, which you can go longer without. Much longer. In fact, the average human can survive for a month without food, as long as they keep their metabolism low. Starvation is a three-step process. In the first part, for the first 6 hours or so after the last meal, the body uses the glucose from that last meal. In this stage, you feel generally well-fed and just go on with your day. The second stage, which lasts for a couple weeks, is a fat-burning stage, where all the extra fat someone acquires goes to an actual use. And in the third stage, the body starts absorbing the energy from your muscles through a process known as catabolysis. The body even goes after heart muscle to try to get as much energy as it can take. In fact, people starving to death often die from cardiac arrest, from the heart being unable to support itself. So, with all this, please be thankful that you have access to food and clean water if you do. Thank you for watching this video. This week, I would like to shout out another channel I really like, Nathan and Rose. They run a scientific channel in much the same form as the Vlog Brothers, talking about scientific subjects, like global warming, through vlogs, and addressing the audience as Nathan or Rose. I met them at VidCon, and they're very, very nice people, and I definitely recommend you check them out. If you want to subscribe to this channel, you can click the yellow subscribe button on screen, or the red subscribe button below screen. Thanks for watching, and remember to appreciate what you have, because some of the things that you already have, you really can't survive long without.
I'm talking about the Wi-Fi, by the way.